In this video, I'm going to show you how to auto-format chapters in Word so that they appear centered and on single pages throughout your document. We'll do this by creating a macro that we assign to an icon that we can put on either the Quick Access Toolbar or on your ribbon. This will help automate a task that would normally be very repetitive if you had to do it manually, and it'll save you a lot of time. If you want to follow along with this video, I'll include a link in the description below, and you can download the Word document, the sample information that we're using today, so you can follow right along. Let's take a look. Here we have a Word document that uses heading styles for different sections of the publication, and I want to insert the chapter title pages before each header section, and I want the chapter title on a single page, centered and towards the middle of the page. So the first thing I'm going to do is come up to my Developer tab. If you don't already have your Developer tab enabled, you can right-click on Customize the Ribbon, and over here on the main tabs, make sure that your Developer tab is checked and click OK. Once you have the Developer tab enabled, go ahead and click on Developer and click on Visual Basic. This will insert a window where we can insert our code for our macro. I'm going to copy this code here. I'll also include it in the description below the video if you're interested in using this particular macro. And what this will do is it's going to insert a section break. It's going to insert some text called chapter title that's going to be centered in the middle of the page. It'll make it bold, 24 size font, and it'll say chapter title. Then we can go through our document, find chapter title, and make our updates. So once I have this entered in, I can click on Save and then close out of the VBA editor. Now what I want to do is create an icon button on my Quick Access Toolbar that will run this macro when I click the button. So then all I have to do is right-click over here on my Quick Access Toolbar, select Customize Quick Access Toolbar, and on Popular Commands, drop down and select Macros. Our new Chapter Title Macros is over here. We can click on it and click Add, and now we can modify this. I'm going to use the title of this macro as Chapter Title, so I'm going to delete what's ahead of that. And then I'm going to pick one of the icons to represent this particular macro that I want to run. I'm going to click this text button here. And then I'm going to click OK. And now this will add the chapter title macro to run with this little button that'll be up here on the Quick Access Toolbar as soon as I click OK. Notice that my macro button is now up here. So I have my cursor placed at the beginning of my document, and I'm going to click my button. Notice that by the click of a button, I've inserted a blank page that has my chapter title, and it's centered toward the middle of the page. It's bold and 24 size font. Now I want to go down and add a new page ahead of my next section. I'm going to hit Enter. I'm going to go up to Insert, Page Break. Now that I have my cursor on the new page, I'm going to click my macro button up here on the Quick Access Toolbar for my chapter title, and it inserts the chapter title. So you can quickly go through your document and add your chapter title ahead of each section. Now, if you don't want to have the button up here on your Quick Access Toolbar, you can actually add the button anywhere on any of the tabs in your ribbon as well. So if I wanted to add it on my Home tab ribbon, all I would have to do is right-click, click on Customize the Ribbon, and I'll do the same thing. I can go to Popular Commands and select Macros. My chapter title macro is here. Now on this side, I have all of the main tabs listed down, so I can decide if I want to put it on my Home tab or on any of the other tabs that might make sense for my button. For now, I'm going to leave it on the Home tab. Now you can also see that on the Home tab, I have several different groups that are already set up. So I can add the button within any of the existing groups. I might want to add it into the font area, or I can create a brand new group at the end of the ribbon. This will insert the new group wherever you have your cursor. I can move it up or down to place it where I want to appear on the ribbon. I'm going to move it back up near the font area. Now I can rename that group. Just click on Rename, and we can call it Chapter Title. We can assign it the same button and click OK. Now that we have the new group named, I can come over here and click on the macro and make sure that I can add it over here. It'll add that under the Chapter Title group, and I can click on this And I can also rename the button. And select an icon. Then click OK. When I'm done, just click OK. Now notice that adds a new grouping up here on the home tab of my ribbon right after the font area called chapter title. So every time I want to run that macro, I can go ahead and click that button. So let's say we have a new section that we want to include in our document. I'm going to make my new section a heading title. And I'm going to place my cursor at the beginning and I'll go up and click on chapter title. And it will insert that chapter title page ahead of that new section. Now we can view all of the pages. And we can see that each section has a chapter title on a single page ahead of each header section. If you do need to make any changes to your macro, you can always come back up to your developer tab, click on macros, select your chapter title, and click on edit. It'll open up your VBA editor and you're able to make any edits that you might need to if you want to make changes or adjustments to your macro. And when you're ready to save your document, you can simply go to file, save a copy or save as, navigate where you want to save your document, and you can save it as a normal Word document. You don't have to save it as a macro-enabled document. You're simply running that macro within the document so that it applies the formatting that you want to automatically. So you can save it as a normal Word document. Now, one more quick thing I want to show you. If you don't already have your macro VBA code, you can actually record a macro and assign that to an icon button on your Quick Access Toolbar. To do that, you're going to come up to your Developer tab and click on Record Macro. Name the macro. We can name it Chapter Title 2. And we can click on this button under Assign Macro to a Button. We can select it and add it to the Quick Access Toolbar, select and click Modify. We can change it to chapter title 2 and select a new button for it and then click OK. Then click OK. This will add the new icon button up here on the Quick Access Toolbar. And notice that my recording macros is activated. So it's going to record all of the steps that I'm going to take to put my chapter title in the middle of the page. I'm going to hit enter several times till I get where I want it. Then I'm going to type chapter title. And I'm going to select that, go to the Home tab. We're going to increase the font size, make it bold, and center it. Now we'll go back up to the Developer tab and click on Stop Recording. Now let's go over here, place our cursor, and test our new macro. It didn't quite work as expected, so let's go ahead and troubleshoot what happened. Click on Macros, select chapter title 2 and click on edit. Let's go ahead and change this code. We're going to say the bold font equals true. And let's move these two items up above where the chapter title is typed out. I'm going to click save and close out of the VBA editor. Now we'll try it again. And click our button, and it works as expected. I hope you found this video helpful. Be sure and give it a thumbs up to like it, and don't forget to share it with your friends who will also find it helpful and help them save time. Visit my website, SharonSmithHR.com. Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.